From the heart of Western Colorado, News Channel 5 This Morning starts now.
Welcome back. Thanks for joining us. I'm so excited to have the international award-winning author, Darlene Quinn, live in the studio. Great to have you here this morning.
It's my pleasure, Megan.
Now, I've been taking a peek at some of these books already because I got them ahead of time. You've got a lot of people that are really into these books. The first one that you came out with was Webs of Power, and these all kind of connect together. Tell me why you started writing these books.
Well, I didn't know I was writing a series. I started with Webs of Power, and I got so hooked into my characters that they just kept going. So after that, Twisted Webs came out. And then some of my readers wanted to know more about my characters. So I wrote the prequel, which is Webs of Fate. Webs of Fate is set in the mid-80s when we still had department stores that weren't all called Macy's.
Right.
And prior to the time when our status symbol became, how much did you save?
Very interesting stuff. Now, you have some experience in the corporate world with this, which is kind of what prompted you to want to write these books. For women that are really into these books, why do you think it helps them kind of feel a bit of empowerment when you read these?
Well, actually, the retail business was what really gave women their power. It was the first area where women became executives. And I do have a lot of very strong women in my books. The background, I write faction. The background of my books is authentic. You can tell exactly what happened to our shopping habits, where we are today. Webs of Power is the corporate takeover of all these stores, except I had to make it realistic. Even though my corporate raider has had 3 nervous breakdowns, liposuction, a facelift,
wow,
and fills his pool with mineral water, it has to be realistic if you're writing fiction. So I did not give my character a wife and family in one city and a mistress and family in the other. All true of the man who fell in love with Bloomingdale's, went after all of the Federated department stores, couldn't afford them, and sold the West Coast to Macy's.
I love this story. Being a fashionista, the history of it is really interesting to me. Yes, I called myself a fashionista. But really quickly, a lot of people say that in these books you can get a lot of takeaway points. And one of the things that you pride yourself on is telling people you can reinvent yourself at any age. So you've got a few points for everybody at home that you've said you really can. And what are some of those things that we've got on that screen?
Actually, at any age, and I've been doing it all my life, follow your passion. What is it you really like to do? What do you like to talk to people about? Then, depending on whether you're reinventing yourself to make money, to make a living, or to make living worthwhile, you check those skills. If you want to make money, what is somebody willing to pay you for?
Okay.
And otherwise, you know, I wasn't ready to sit back and clean my closets and play tennis. I needed something more. And network. Networking is more available today than any time. The social medias, I'm on all of them. Facebook, Twitter, LinkedIn.
I've got to add you.
Yeah, absolutely add me. And you people out there as well. But tell people what you want. It is amazing. Every time I talk to groups of people, I say, how many people really enjoy helping someone else? All the hands go up. And yet, as human beings, we are so reluctant to ask for help, and we're denying people that opportunity to help us.
Darlene, it's been an absolute pleasure having you in the studio this morning. It's really inspirational. I really suggest all of you check out these books. They've got a great message, and if you want more information, you can visit her website at darlenequinn.net. And we'll also have this whole interview on our web channel at krextv.com if you missed any of her great points. And again, thank you so much for being here this morning.
Thank you, Megan. It was my pleasure.